Welcome to Great Basin National Park. We're about to take a virtual tour of Lehman Caves and head to the Grand Palace, the farthest section of the cave accessible on the tour. My name is Ranger Alicia, and I'll be your tour guide. Throughout the tour, we'll explore the history, geology, hydrology, and biology of the cave. During our time together, we will also explore the fundamental question of why life enters the cave in the first place. However, before we do so, it's critical to understand the answer won't be summarized in a single idea. This tour will be broken up into three videos. The first video will cover the tour route from the entrance tunnel to the entrance of the lodge room. The second video will cover the tour route from the Queen's Bath to the Grand Palace. And the last leg of our journey will cover the lodge room to the exit tunnel. During our trip, this bat icon will pop up at points of interest. Click on the bat when it appears to get more information and maximize your virtual cave tour experience. Entering a cave, for most, is entering a completely unknown world, one where time seems to come to a halt, and the pressures of the real world cease to exist. Maybe it was this feeling that encouraged Absalom Lehman to welcome visitors, and maybe it was this sensation that invited early settlers to brave the darkness of the cave. No matter the feelings or sensations the cave could invoke, many people would have used a much different method to enter than we just did. Although evidence shows human visitation to the cave over the past 1,000 years, it's only a brief point in history compared to what has been going on underground for much longer. The age of Lehman Caves is estimated to be between 2 to 10 million years old. During that time, warm water that was naturally rich in sulfuric and carbonic acid rose beneath the mountain. Once that water encountered the marble bedrock, it dissolved the rock until it created these passageways and rooms. Eventually, the water table lowered, providing the opportunity for water from the surface to enter the newly created space and begin to develop many of the formations called speleothems. Looking to the ceiling, we can see icicle-like structures called stalactites. On the cave floor, we can see formations growing up towards the ceiling. These are called stalagmites. When stalactites and stalagmites grow together, we call the resulting structure a column, as we can see on the left. If the labels prove difficult to remember, a good verse to have in mind is, "Stalactites have to hang on tight." Stalagmites, you might trip over them, and together you call them a column. No matter how or what you use to remember the names of different speleothems, they are just one of the phases of the geologic development of the cave. When Absalom Lehman first gazed on the beauty of this underground world, he decided to open the area to the public by turning it into a tourist attraction. Early visitors to the cave paid a small fee to enter, and Mr. Lehman allowed them to explore the space using either a torch or lantern. Over time, as visitation continued to increase, many pieces of the cave have been removed or broken off to allow people to explore farther, as well as to take pieces home as gifts or souvenirs. Do you see this small piece of growth extending from the broken piece of the cave? Can you guess how long it took to grow? Go ahead and take a second to think of an answer. Based on the regrowth of soda straws from this early destruction, we see that Speleothems grow about 0 to 4 inches per century. Actions of past generations damaged parts of the cave. We are continually learning from these mistakes. Different groups have used the cave in various ways. While humans have used the cave for a variety of reasons, we're not the only ones who have ventured into the dark. Many different organisms call Lehman Caves home, some of whom, like the Snake Range cave millipede, can only be found in and near Great Basin National Park. One special species has passed its home down for generations and offers researchers a glimpse into the past. While many wood rat middens have persisted for millennia, the age of these organic structures barely registers against the durability of the mineral formations surrounding them. The path we're following is the same route by which park rangers take visitors through Lehman Caves today. But this wasn't always the route people used. Before this area was protected as a national monument in 1922, the tour itself took different passages. For example, the tour route we're currently taking used to traverse an alternate way because the passage ahead was blocked. It wasn't until a large section of rock was excavated and placed to the side that this staircase could be installed, allowing for easier access to the rest of the cave. During our time together, we have encountered many different ways people and animals have viewed the cave, from a source of profit, to show cave, to shelter, and even as a spiritual place. In our next video, we'll learn about some tiny organisms and the history of a few cave visitors. And we will explore the largest and most decorated space on the tour route, the Grand Palace. If you wish to continue with the virtual tour, please click the following video to experience the majesty that is Lehman Caves.